Hello friends, now we see the problem number 9, which is based on the sum of force n terms of a GP of chapter, sequence and series. The question is, if S1, S2 and S3 are respectively the sum of n, 2n, 3n terms of a GP, then prove that S1 in bracket S3 minus H2 is equal to H2 minus S1 whole bracket square. Now let's see the solution. The solution is very simple. First of all, we consider let A and R be the first term and common ratio of a GP. Since S1 here represent sum of first n terms of a GP, therefore S1 is equal to A in bracket 1 minus R raise n upon 1 minus R. Let us this denote as a equation 1. Then H2 represent the sum of first 2n terms of a GP. Therefore, H2 is equal to A in bracket 1 minus R2n upon 1 minus R. Let us this denote as a equation number 2. On the same line, S3 represent the sum of first 3n terms of a GP. Therefore, S3 is equal to A in bracket 1 minus R raise 3n whole thing divided by 1 minus R. Let us this denote as a equation number 3. Now we find H2 minus S1. For H2, we substitute value from equation 2. We get A in bracket 1 minus R2n whole thing divided by 1 minus R, then minus for S1 by using equation 1 can be written as A in bracket 1 minus R raise n upon 1 minus R. Now from this we take A upon 1 minus R common, we get A in bracket 1 minus R, then we left with 1 minus R2n from first term minus 1 minus R2n from second term. So that equal to A upon 1 minus R in square bracket. If we simplify the bracket, we get 1 minus R2n minus 1 plus R2n. So that equal to A in bracket upon 1 minus R in bracket. Now in bracket, plus 1 minus 1 cancel. So we left with R raise n minus r raise 2n. From that, we take r raise n common. So the next step will be a into r raise n in bracket 1 minus r raise n whole thing divided by 1 minus r. So in this way we get h2 minus s1 is equal to a into r raise n upon 1 minus r into 1 minus r raise n. Let us this denote as a equation number 4. Now we consider S3 minus H2. Is equal to A in bracket 1 minus R raise 3N upon 1 minus R minus, for H2 we write A in bracket 1 minus r raise 2n upon 1 minus r. From these two terms we take a upon 1 minus r common. So in bracket we have 1 minus r raise 3n minus, in second bracket we have 1 minus r raise 2n and the square bracket complete. So that equal to a upon 1 minus r in bracket, if we simplify the bracket we get 1 minus r raise 3n minus 1 plus r raise 2n. So that equal to a upon 1 minus r in bracket, here plus 1 and minus 1 we cancel, so we get r raise 2n minus r raise 3n, bracket complete. And from that we take r raise 2n common. So the next step will be a into r raise 2n whole thing divided by 1 minus r in bracket 1 minus r raise n. So this is answer for s3 minus h2. Now this S3 minus H2, this whole bracket we have to multiply with S1. So the next step will be S1 into S3 minus H2. So that equal to, for S1 we write A in bracket 1 minus R raise N upon 1 minus R. And that multiply by S3 minus H2 we have A into RH2N upon 1 minus R into 1 minus R raise N, bracket complete. Therefore, the next step will be S1 in bracket S3 minus H2 is equal to, so here we rearranging the term as A into R raise N into 1 minus r raised n whole thing divided by 1 minus r, and now this whole bracket square, and therefore s1 in bracket s3 minus s2 is equal to, now a into r raised n into 1 minus r raised n upon 1 minus r. This is nothing but from equation 4 s2. Therefore, s1 in bracket s3 minus s2 is equal to. Now, if you here observe right hand side that a into r raised n into 1 minus r raised n upon 1 minus r whole bracket square. Now, this is nothing but our equation number 4. So, therefore, finally we get s1 in bracket s3 minus s2 is equal to s2 minus s1 the whole bracket square. So, in this way, we prove the questions. Thank you.